ओके आयुष, सॉरी ओके नॉट आयुष, ओके सिद्धार्थ, यू हैव डन थ्री। इशू हैज डन थ्री, गुड। अंशिका थ्री, गुड। अक्षित हैज डन थ्री, गुड। अंतरा हैज डन टू, ओके। एनीवन एल्स? वी हैव अराउंड 47 स्टूडेंट्स। पलक टू, ओके। सो लेट मी रिमाइंड व्हाट वर द क्वेश्चंस। सो दीज वर लाइक फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वी डिड टुमॉरो, येस्टरडे वॉज टू सम, इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन। नेक्स्ट वी डिड वॉज थर्ड मैक्सिमम नंबर। आई आस्क्ड यू टू डू दीज थ्री क्वेश्चंस ऑन योर ओन, मूव जीरोज, रोटेट एरे एंड फाइंड द डुप्लीकेट नंबर। So all everyone has done first two questions, okay? Everyone has done. Is there anyone who hasn't done first two questions? Because if you don't practice this question, then there is no point of this session, okay? If you have any doubt, any issue in your logic, then you can talk about it with me, okay? If you don't do those questions actually on lead code, then theory won't help you, okay? Only practice will help you, okay? It's fine. Let's wait for 1 or 2 minutes, then we will start. I will first explain to you what is two pointer approach, and then we will discuss how to solve this non-zero question, the third question, with the help of this. Then we will discuss the solution and code in C++, Java, Python. Then we'll talk rotate array, and then we will discuss the find the duplicate number question, okay? So anyone has doubt any first two questions, if anyone want to discuss it again? Okay, so let's start, okay? So a two pointer approach is a very common used technique. So in this, what we can do, you are hearing that there are two pointers. So mainly we apply it to array, and we can also apply it to other data structure, but it is mostly applied to array only. So anyone else left to join? So in this, what we do, we take two variables. One is called pointer one and another variable is called pointer two. We usually started one from the start and second from the end. We can also start from the middle or any other position you like, but the core concept is that there will be two variables accessing the same data structure at the same time on the basis of different conditions that we want to achieve in our problem. So we have one pointer starting from starting and second pointer starting from the end. Yaar ek baar mein aa jao sab. Can you, Neelam? I always record a session. So it's on OBS Studio. Okay, so we were discussing two pointer approach. What we do, we take two variables, pointer one, pointer two. These are nothing but just variables which will help us access a different part of an array. So it starts from the first and it go to second, third, fourth, and it will start from last to second last, third last, fourth last. So this is a simple logic. We will take a variable, and let's say we take a variable, let me show you some code for it, the pseudo code for this algorithm, and then we will understand it with the help of an example. So I'm just telling the pseudo code, it's not in any specific language, so don't worry about it. I'm just telling you the logic of it, how a two pointer algorithm works, because lot of question you will solve on two pointer approach. The next algorithm we'll do in further session will be sliding window. That is also very important. Okay, let's say we have an array, something like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 7. Okay, so what we'll do, we will define two variables, start var str start, let me point to start, and we will initialize it to 0. Then we take another variable var and equals to the last index, that will be the 7th index, so end will point to 7. So this will be called as pointer 1 and this will be called as pointer 2. So this is the core logic behind this two pointer, is just a variable. How we will access that, we will take some logic, some loop will go here, okay, and what we will do, we will access the array start and array end. So this is how we will access the values with the help of these pointers that we have defined. These are not the pointers in a sense you have seen pointers in C or C++. These are just two variables that will point to two different parts of a data structures. Okay, so the core concept of two pointer approach is clear to everyone. Anyone has any doubt in this? Cool. So this is what the basic thing. Let's understand with the help of a problem. Yesterday we did that two sum problem. Let me explain the problem for the students who are new. So we were given an array. One second, I'm coming back. So let's understand two pointer approach with the help of two sum problem we have discussed yesterday. So how many students have done it, two sum? Everybody has done it now? Anyone who hasn't done, please let me know. Okay, fine. So in this, what we were supposed to do, we are given an array, 2, 7, 11, 15, or any set of array can be given. We are given a target value x, y, z. So we have to find the pair whose sum will be equal to the target. Let's say sum of 2 and 7 is 9. So we have to return the indices of 2 and 7, that is 0 and 1. Let's say in this case, 3 to 4, the target is 6. We have to return the indices of 2 and 4, 1 and 2. So this was a simple problem that we did yesterday. Okay. So what we did yesterday, we used two loops to compare every number. We used the brute force approach. Now we are going to solve this problem with the help of two pointer. So I will explain you the pseudocode, the logic behind it. You can write code on yourself. Okay. So array is sorted. Let's say the array is sorted. In the any case, array is not sorted. It won't difference in this. This is a special condition of two sum where the array is sorted. So in this case, we can apply the two pointer, because in a non-sorted way it will be difficult to be applied. Okay, so what we'll do, we will take a pointer start with the first index and end at the last index. Okay, so we will keep on checking the sum of start and end and compare it with the target. So here, what is the sum? 1 and 60 is 61, and what is the target? Is 40. So in this situation, target is 40. Okay, everyone is clear? So this doesn't match, we will decrement the end. It will go 45. If the total sum that is coming 61 is above 40, the target, then we'll decrement the value. If it is lesser, then we will increment the start. Okay, everybody is understanding the question that we are discussing? Any doubt to anyone with approach, with what question we are trying to solve? Because if you don't understand it, it will be difficult for you to understand the solution. Good. Okay, so this is a sorted array. This is a two sum simple problem. This is a unique problem where the array is given in a sorted order. So what we are given, we are given a target of 40. We have taken two pointers, start for the first number and end for the last number. So what we are going to do, we are going to increment start and decrement end by checking whether the sum of these number is greater than the target. If it is greater than the target, then obvious we have to reduce its value. Okay, so we will decrement the end pointer.
इफ इट इज़ वैल्यूज लेसर देन द टारगेट तो इट मीन्स वी हैव टू इंक्रीज द वैल्यू वी विल इंक्रीमेंट द स्टार्ट पॉइंटर सो दैट लॉजिक वी आर गोइंग टू यूज सो इन द फर्स्ट केस 1 विल बी कंपेयर्ड विद 60 61 इट इज़ ग्रेटर देन 40 सो 60 विल बी डिक्रीमेंटेड एंड इट विल कम डाउन टू 45 45 प्लस 1 इज 46 विच इज़ ग्रेटर देन 40 ओके सो वी विल अगेन डिक्रीमेंट Now you will see is 32 plus 1 is 33 which is less than 40. So in this case we are going to increment the start. So start is increment from first index to second index. Now end will stay here. Okay. So it will be 5 plus 32. It will be 37 which is less than 40. So we will increment it again. Then we will found 8 and 32 which will be the ultimate answer. Okay. So this is a simple way that I have described you two pointer approach. Okay. So we take two variables. Mostly we take it from the starting and at the end. You can also take at the middle, you can also take somewhere else, wherever you want, wherever is the need, depending on the logic of your problem. But mostly we take it in the start and the ending only, okay? So let's look at the next question that we are doing. Third question we have to study today is, third question of the bootcamp is non-zeros. We have to shift all the zeros at the end. I have explained you the question. Lot of students must have attempted it. Let me first try to explain you what is the problem. Then I will ask students who have submitted it to tell their approach. And then I will tell my approach and we will discuss the code in each language. So we are given an array, any array 0, 1, 0, 3, 12. So what we have to do, we have to push all the zeros to the end and all the numbers to the start. But we have to maintain the relative order. If like 1 is coming before 3, so it has to come in the output as well before 3. You cannot sort it, which means you cannot sort this to achieve your objective. Okay. So this is a simple problem. Students who have solved this question, kindly let me know their approach in the comments. You don't have to tell the code, you just have to tell your approach. So lots of students have said they have done 3 and 5 problems, so they can discuss in the. Also, the students who are seeing it for the first time, please open this problem. I'll adding the link again in the chat and try to understand it and think of the approach, because the more you think, so lots of students ask me, sir, ki programming ability kaise badhaye, how do we improve our programming thinking or logic kaise build kare, how to build a logic. This is how you build a logic. You go, you read the problem, you read again and again, you try some solution, you improve it, you do wrong, then you do wrong. So this is hard work you have to do. So please think and do. So one approach is, Rishabh has said, you can count the zero and then you can just swap all the numbers against zero and add that number of zeros in the end. Okay, this is one approach that we can do. Animesh, double pointer approach, okay, very good. We can do a double pointer approach, okay, that's what we are going to use as well. Okay, Raj Kesarwani, you have done the same as Rishabh has mentioned, okay? Anyone else? Double pointer, okay. Count zero, okay. After that, append zero in out. Add new list, okay. Sort, no, Amrit, we cannot sort, because I told you we have to maintain the relative order. Like initially, if you sort it, then it will become like, let's say it is 1, 12 and 3. So if you sort it, the output will be 1, 3 and 12. You have to maintain that relative order, so you cannot sort this array, okay? Double pointer approach, okay. So we have these two approaches where you have to count 0 and then add 0 at the last. So both of these approaches will get us the desired approach answer, but we have to now think which is the most optimal one. We cannot make any copy. Okay, so what do you think, which approach do you think, double pointer is better or this counting of zeros is better? So, okay, tell me how many iterations it will take for counting 0 and adding 0 at the end. You will first go through the array and count the zeros, and in the second approach you will go and then add the zeros in the end, right? That's how you are going to do. Yes, ON, but it's ON, I agree, but iterations will be two, right? Yes, iterations will be 2. So can we do it in single iteration, that we don't have to go to the array twice? So is there any way we can do it in single iteration? So two iterations is okay. I got your point. You just go there around, count all the numbers, keep all the one in the starting, like you will go from left to right, you will count one and you will move one to here and count 0, 2, 3 will come to the second position, 12 will come to the second position. Okay. But it will take two iterations. So how can we do it in single iteration? Please think about it. So for that we are going to use double pointer approach. Is anyone is thinking? If you need more time, so let me know. I will wait for a few more minutes. Okay, so let me discuss the two pointer approach that we are going to use here. Right now I don't have a Jamboard or something, I don't have a mouse, so I won't be able to draw you, but I'll tell you what we are going to do. What we are going to do, we will take this array, we will take a pointer that will point to the starting and a pointer that will point to the last. Okay, so we will call the first pointer as the first zero, like first zero we are going to find out. Okay, so whenever we found zero, we will swap it with the last index. Okay, so this is what we are going to keep doing and incrementing the value to the right. So let me draw, it won't be possible without it. Let me try it with touchpad. Access denied, keh raha bhai tumhara jam ho to. Okay, so let me try with this. I haven't used it any time. Okay, so we'll use it. Let's say we have this array 010312. Okay. Please ignore my writing, okay. So this is the array that we are going to do. So we will take two pointers, as we can say F or we can say E. Okay. So we will initially point one to the start and second will go where? To the last zero. Okay. So it will be the last zero that we are going to take. So initially we will take both the pointer in the start, non-zero as well as F, and we are going to check if that is a zero or not. If it is a zero, we will swap it to the next index that we are having in our place. Currently we will have no one. So what we'll do, it is zero only. So what we'll do, we'll take it F to the next pointer. Okay. Okay, so this is a non-zero. What we will do, we will swap these number. So one will come here and zero, sorry, my speed is very slow with this one, and this will happen and E will come to this location. E will come to the second index and F will go on to the next number. This will happen. One iteration is okay to everyone. In the next iteration, what we are going to do, F will point to next zero. X F will point to this, but it is a zero, so we cannot do anything about it. We will keep it here and move on to the next iteration. Now F will come to this. Okay, so it is a non-zero. What we'll do, you will swap three with zero. So what will happen? Three will come here and zero will come here. What is the next iteration? F will go to the 12. okay, so f will go to the 12, then it will swap also, e will also be incremented in the last line after the swap. So I missed that part. So now 12 will be swapped with 3. So this is how this approach is going to work. It's a very simple approach. Don't do that counting approach, do only two pointer approach, because these kind of questions are meant to be solved with two pointer approach. Okay, is this approach clear to everyone? Do you have any doubts? Please let me know, everyone, not Ayush and other students. Good. So do you want to try it on your own, or I show you the code first? You take the idea from this approach and try it on your own. Okay, try it. Let's wait for 4 minutes. It's 6:26. I will give you 4 minutes to code this logic. I will keep this diagram here so that you can refer it if you need. You have to take two pointers initially pointing to first number, and everybody is saying they are trying, so please try for a few minutes, then we will tell. Okay, everyone has the lead code account, na? Is there anyone who doesn't have a lead code account? Okay, Priya, so kindly create one, go to this leadcode.com. So it will just log in with your Gmail account and it will just happen in a minute. Is it clickable? No. Let me add the complete link. So just go here and sign up with your Gmail and it will be done in a second. Okay, you are not able to approach Ayush. What is the issue you are facing in coding? You have to just take two variables. One variable will be pointing to the non-zero number, and second variable will be the iteration that will keep on going from left to right. One will be last zero and one will be the non-zero that will keep on going from left to right. So just take two variables and iterate the loop. It will take only single iteration. Simple for loop will be taken, it's just a 4-line code. Okay, Priya, do it definitely and complete your problems and by watching the video recording or anything you want, okay? But make sure you do, okay? These are very, very simple questions, very beginner level. We will slowly increase the level of our questions that we are doing. Okay, so let's look at the code, okay? So I'll first tell you a C++ code. I will show you lead code first. So this is the method. If somebody is coding for the first time in lead code, let me tell you, you don't have to take any input. You don't have to take show any output. You just have to understand the return type. It's void, so you just don't have to do anything. You have to just take the input, perform all your operations in this section and submit your code. You don't have to take any input or anything like that. So what we are going to do, we are going to take first index that we are pointer is last zero. That will keep the track of which is the last zero we have. Like in this case, we had e e pointed to the last zero wherever we had it. Next index was non-zero, which kept out iterating from left to right to right to right to right to till the end. Okay, so these are the two. You can name it anything. Variable naming is not a problem. Whichever is helpful to you, you can take that name. So don't get confused by that. So last zero is initialized to zero. Non-zero is also initialized to zero because we are taking it part of a for loop. So for loop will start from non-zero equals to zero. Non-zero less than nums dot size. Nums dot size is a function of STL. If you don't know STL, then it's a simple vector which works like an array. Okay, so they are also passing the address of it, which means a pointer is passed, so you don't have to return anything. Okay, and non-zero plus plus. So what we'll do, you will check if the index you have taken is not equal to zero, which means you have to swap. So in this case, we also checked when the number was a non-zero, we swapped. If it is a zero, we just skip to the next iteration. Okay, so what you'll do is simple swapping you have taken with a temporary variable, that nothing else in this, and you just increment the last zero plus plus, which I forgot to do in one case. Okay, after the swap, you will increment the last zero index. Very simple logic, very simple code, nothing fancy about it. Do try it on your own. Okay, let's look at Java code. Is almost same, there is only one difference. Nums dot size, you are going to use nums dot length. You take the last zero equals to zero, non-zero zero less than nums dot length, non-zero plus plus. If nums non-zero is not equal to zero, you swap and then you increment the value of last zero. Okay, let's look at the Python code. In this you have main move zeros and nums. Nums here is a list and not an array or a vector. Last zero is initialized to zero. What is happening? And for loop you are going to start for non-zero in range length of num, len num. So it will give the number of elements in that array. If num non-zero is not equal to zero, you are going to swap. So this is how you swap in Python using a comma. Okay, so I hope if you are in Python, you are aware. You can also use the third variable concept as well. There is no load to use this cool thing. Okay, and at the end you just increment last zero plus equal to one. Okay, there are no increment operators in Python. Okay, is code clear to everyone in all the languages? How many have submitted the question on the lead code? Just now who have done, like not before, previous students not. Can somebody share their profile, lead code profile link, so that I can show to the students how it will look on their profile? Okay, I'll show you the code, C++ code I will show. So this is the code. Good, Diksha. Okay, Aman, your code is right, very simple. Why we initialize pause? I think you can do it with the I as well. Yeah, you can do it with I as well. There is no need for take additional variable or pause. You can do it with I as well. Okay, Aman. So someone share their lead code profile. I will show how submissions look on your profile. Please don't feel shy about it. Okay. I will show mine if you have a problem. No, share the link, Venkatesh. How will I use this username? So we are seeing Venkatesh profile. We will see few more as well. So this is how your code will look like. Move zeros, you have submitted the language, it will show you have submitted twice. Okay, there was no need to do it twice. Okay, that's how it will look on your profile.
So first you just run the code, like you just locally run the code and then you submit later, because there are sometimes many test cases which are not public and there are private test cases, okay? So for that you can definitely do it, okay? You can just run locally. You can just run code here. If you want to test, you can check the test cases which are passed. You can change those test cases to test your code in different circumstances. Okay, so all the functionality flexibility is provided to you. Okay, good. Whose was this? You haven't done non-zeros. Okay, do it as well, Ayush. So everyone has done, or do we have to discuss more about this problem so that we move on to the next problem? Yes, you have done. The first attempt was wrong and second was right. Okay, good. That's how we learn. So you have done all the five questions. Good, Aman. Great. So let's move on to the second question. If somebody has doubt, you can watch the recording and try this question later at home. Okay. Home, PG, house, wherever you're living. Next question is very interesting question. It's a simple question. If I have just asked you to rotate by one step, two step, three step, to bahut easy ho jata, but I have generalized this and asked you to do it by k steps. Okay, so then it becomes slightly interesting because you have to rotate the array by k step. It's not one step, two step, three step. You have to do it with a k step. Let me take the solution again, question again, sorry. So we have this array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and we are given k as an input. It will divide how many steps we have to shift it to the right. Let's say if we have to shift it one step, it will become 1 will go to right, 2 will go to right, 3 will go will right, and 7 will come in the starting. So this will be the output. What will be the next step from here? 1 will go further right, all values will go right, and 6 will come in the starting. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And one more thing you have to step 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So what are the question is okay to everyone? Like, question is quite simple. So they are saying that there are at least three different ways to solve this problem. Can you do it in place and oven? So please think about it as well. I hope question is clear. So let me know your approaches that you have applied for this problem in the chat section. यस वी कैन रोटेट बट हाउ, डैट इज़ द क्वेश्चन ना मधु. क्वेश्चन यही है रोटेट करना है के टाइम्स, बट हाउ एग्जैक्टली? थिंक थिंक थिंक. लेट मी एड द लिंक एज वेल अगेन. Anyone? काफ़ी बच्चों ने कर रखा है. यू गैस टेल. ओके, गुड आयुष. ये रिवर्स वाला सॉल्यूशन इज अ गुड सॉल्यूशन, बट यू जस्ट कांट गेट टू दिस सॉल्यूशन डायरेक्टली. इट इज समथिंग दैट विल टेक यू टाइम टू गेट अराउंड, राइट? सो फर्स्ट सॉल्यूशन यू विल थिंक लाइक रोटेट बाय सिंगल and then recursively call that function k times. Okay, make a simple function that will rotate a array by one point and you call it 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, how many times you want to do, like what Yash has also said. So this is the first solution that will come to your mind. Okay, this is the intuitive and basic solution that will come to anyone's mind. Next would be to reverse and everything else. So rotate is very simple. You can just make a function that will rotate all the numbers one by one to the right, and then you call that number n number of times. Okay, now what approach we are going to use will be reversing it. So I've given you a hint, please try. You have to reverse the number. You can read what Ayush has written. So this approach we are going to use, and if you want some time to try on your own, you can first try, then I will let me first explain the approach and then you try. But if I explain the approach, it will become very easy, no? So what do you want me to do? First explain the approach or give you time to think? Anyone, let me know in the chat. Okay, think. I'll give you 3 minutes. Think for 3 minutes. Open the question on LeetCode and take your time. You are right, Arun, but you have swapped your second and third step. First you will do the third step and then you will do the second step, okay? Or you can do reverse as well, it won't matter, I think. Okay, Diksha, how you are going to use? Arun, you're right, both will give the same answer. Is there any condition given on the number of k? Also keep in mind that this k can be greater than the length of this array, like its size is 7, k can also be 8, it can also be 12, it can also be 20. So there is no restriction given on the value of k. It's given from 0 to 10 to the power 5. So make sure you include this condition in your logic. Okay. For I in range nums dot insert. Yes, you have to do this, okay? Yeah, sure. So will that work? Is that enough, this code? Nums dot insert. So that's all code, Diksha, or is there something else with it? Okay. Let me try to run it in mine. Okay, great. So can you explain what's happening in this line of code? Okay, so you have taken from 0 to k number of elements from the end and inserted in the starting. Okay, and you have popped it at the end. Okay, that's also good. Haan, ye bhi matlab sahi hai. In other language you can swap it, okay? Yes, it will work in Python, but if you were to do it in C++ or Java, you have to do lot of swapping, no? You have to keep all the numbers to the right. So how will it happen in C++ or Java? Also, if you want to see the detailed solution of all these five problems, there is a separate video of 30 minutes. I will share the link. You can watch it in your idle time if you have a lot of time with you. This one.
So it's 3, 6, 10 elements.
One second. Detailed solution you will find with diagrams of all these five problems. Okay. So anyone who has tried. Okay, so let me discuss the approach that we are going to use here. Yeah, clear is easy. So we have this array. What is the array? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So we have given k equals to 3. Okay. So we are given k equals to 3. So what we'll do? We will first reverse the whole array, so it will become 7, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1. So this will be your array after reversal. So what we will do, you can either first swap, reverse these k digits, these are k digits, and these are your n minus k digit. So you can either first reverse first k digit or first n minus k. I am going to do the n minus k digit first. So you will reverse them. So it will become 7, 6, 5, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then you reverse these 3, that is k digit, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this will be the output which is expected, 5, 7, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. It will work at any number case, any situation, it's going to work. So this is a very simple approach we are going to use. Because problem with this logic is that it's not going to work in other languages, in C++ or Java. That's why we recommend to not use Python for DSA and CP, because it has lots of inbuilt methods and which really, really makes it difficult to create your logic. That's why C++ or Java is recommended for DSA and CP. Okay, so this is a simple logic you have to use. Reverse the whole array and then you reverse either k first and then n minus k. So let me show you with the help of code. So this is the code in C++. We are given a rotate function with vector nums and int k. Okay. One second, let me take this call.
हेलो
हाँ प्रत्युष
हाँ सर पावर डाउन हो गया बहुत बारिश हो रहा है
अच्छा थोड़ी देर बाद दे देना ठीक है
वो ठीक है सर मैं क्लास बोल रहे थे हम क्या करें क्लास साढ़े सात तक लगता नहीं लाइन आएगा बहुत तेज बारिश हो रहा है पूरा बताए थे ना बालकनी साइड से पानी आने लग गया पूरा अंदर
ठीक है आप उन्हें बता दो इन्फॉर्म कर दो ओके
ठीक है हम सैटरडे को ले लेंगे सर सर फ्राइडे सैटरडे लगातार ले लेंगे
ठीक है या सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग द कोड So you are given a nums input, that is the array, the k input. So we are doing this k percentile nums dot size. So what this thing is doing, let me explain you. Let's say the array size is 7, okay, and we are given the value as 12, okay. So if the value is given as 5, so how many rotations will happen? Will 5 will happen. If k is given as 12, so how many rotation, relative rotation will happen? It won't happen 12, it will still happen 12 minus 7, that will be 5 rotation. If the value is 27, sorry, it's not minus this, it's the multiple of it. 7 into 1 will be 7, which is nearest to 12, and you counted by minus it from 7, so it will be 5 only, okay. So for 27, 7 into 3, 21, and minus from this, it will be 6. So your ultimate rotation will be 6 in this case. So we are doing this with the help of modulus operator. So what will give? It will give the remainder, and which will become the k in our effective case. So let's say if there are 10 elements and you are given like 93 value, so the effective rotation will be only 3, and if you divide 93 by 10, so the remainder will come as 3. Okay. So what we'll do, we'll take a recursive function of reverse, a simple function, not a recursive function, sorry. So we have created a separate function reverse. It takes array, it takes the start index, it takes the end index. So we are going to use a while loop, which will start from start. It's again two pointers. Start will point from first and end will point from, point from end. And it will swap those values and increment the start and decrement the end. So very simple reverse logic of an array. Okay, I hope you are able to understand quite clearly. So what we'll call it for nums from 0 to all. Matlab whole array will be reversed. Then you call it from k to last, or you can call it from 0 to k minus 1 first, whichever you like. I like this way. Okay, then you call it from 0 to k minus 1, as I have shown you here. First, whole of it is reversed. And then part of it is reversed, n minus k, n k, and that's how you get the result. Okay, so very simple approach we are going to use. In Java, similarly, k equals to k percentile nums dot length. You reverse 0 to total whole array, then you reverse from k to last, then you reverse from 0 to k minus 1, and this is the simple reverse function. Two pointers you have taken, swap, 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 start plus plus, end minus minus, okay. And in Python, you can either use that logic, because if someone says that you cannot use any inbuilt function, so then you have to use this logic, okay. Simple rotate k modulus length. 0 total length, k to end, 0 to k minus 1, num start end, and the reversal of it. Okay. Anyone, any query in this question? I hope you will be having some queries. Good. So please try this question. I think next question, let's discuss quickly. There is not enough time for it. So how did you do, if anyone has done this third question, you have to find a duplicate number. There are 1 to n number, there is exactly one number which is repeated. So how you guys have done it, anyone can let me know their approach in the comments. So there are some, you can do sorting, so it will give you n log n. You can also do it with the help of a set, but it will give you an extra space complexity of on additionally. So what we are going to use is cycle detection here. So what you guys have used, yeah, we can create another vector, but problem is we don't want to take additional space of on. We want to do it in the same array itself. Anyone else, any approach? I'll put the link so that if anyone wants to open it. Yep. Tortoise in Hare is there. No doubt about that. But getting to that solution is not possible, because when you solve a problem, you start from a brute force approach, okay? Then you take a slightly optimized version of it. Then you take it next level and slowly, slowly optimize it, okay? So what can be the brute force approach here? Can we think? One thing will come first to your mind, like sort it. Yeah, n log n, we will sort it and then we'll traverse it again. And in two traversal, we will find the solution. Okay. What can be other approach we can think of? Anyone, any idea? So take more time. If you want to take more time, we will discuss it again. We don't want to take extra space, na Antra? Hash map set is always there, right? Any problem can be solved with the help of a hash map, okay? But first try to use all the logics, exhaust all your options, then go to hash map. Compare each element. Yeah, we can do that. That will be the n square approach. Brute force that I was talking about. You take each number and compare it with everybody else. Sure. Two loops is the brute force approach. Yes, we can sort it, okay? So that's taken approach. It will take n log n and a further iteration of n. So n log n plus n, that will be n log n itself. Okay, so let's end this session here. 7 p.m. I have other engagement. We will also discuss this, no, not map issue. So we will also discuss this solution tomorrow as well, if time permits. And I will also give you two more problems to do that we'll do tomorrow. Solution of this problem, you can check on this website or video that I'm sharing with you. So you will find it at around 15 to 20 minutes. This solution is discussed. It will take me at least 15 to 20 minutes to explain this solution. It's very lengthy. So I have to first build the premise, like what is the thesis behind this logic and why we have हम यहाँ तक पहुँचे कैसे, हाउ वी अराइव टू दिस सॉल्यूशन. सो दैट्स ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू थिंक. लेट मी गिव यू टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन वी आर गोइंग टू डू विच आर वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू यूज नेक्स्ट परम्यूटेशन. लेट मी एक्सप्लेन वॉट इट इज. सो यू आर गिवन एनी एरे, एनी नंबर लाइक 7, 3, 2, 5. सो यू हैव टू रिटर्न द नेक्स्ट नंबर इन द लेक्सिकोग्राफिकल सिक्वेंस. लाइक I am given 1, 2, 3. So what will be the next number form with this digit? That will be 132. So it's 123 is 132. I am given 321. If the next number is not possible, you have to just reverse the numbers. You have to give the lowest number. So it's mentioned here in the conditions. Input is 115. You have to, what will be the next number you can form? You can either form 511. You can either form 115 is already there, so 151 is the answer. So this is the approach. It's a very interesting question. How many attempts it has? It's have around 15 lakh attempts. Yeah, 15 lakhs. Okay, so it's a very medium level problem. Do try it at home and do try, think if you are able to solve, else we will discuss it in the next session. The next question we are going to do, it's a very common Dutch national flag problem. It's also said red, white, blue, green, sorry, what kind of heads are taken in it. It's a very famous problem, so we are going to also cover this problem. So we'll do 7 problems in array. So I was thinking we will do it today, but it took us more time. So it's a very highly rated problem. You can see so many likes, so less dislikes. So what we have to do, we are given an array of zeros and ones and two. We have to sort it in a way we get zeros first, then ones first, then twos first. Okay, so there are some conditions before you think of sorting. Let me tell you we have to do it in place, which means we cannot use any additional constant extra space, we will not take any extra space, and without using the inbuilt sort function, okay, or we cannot use any other sorting algorithm that you might think of, okay. So this is a very simple question. We are going to do these two questions next, so do try it on your own and you can understand the logic behind the third question that was supposed to be discussed today. That is the find the duplicate number on this video. I have mentioned the link. This is created by me itself. It will take at least 15 to 20 minutes to explain the solution to this problem. Okay, so I hope I am clear. So kindly complete all your five questions prior to this session and two questions given in this session, and we will first discuss these questions tomorrow and then we'll move on to what we are going to do tomorrow. Strings, yeah, string is very easy, so we will do less of string and more of array. Okay.